Welcome back. This is The Local Show, a service of Safe Harbor Wills and Trusts on News Radio 570 WSYR.
All the waiters in your grand cafe leave their tables when you blink. Oh, every
backstroking into The Local Show. Here we go. Swimming right in on this weekend. Hope you're having fun, enjoying fall so far. So my neighbors are throwing it right in my face as they start to dig out their beautiful in-ground pool.
So how are they throwing it in your face? If you didn't, you just have envy, Tom.
Steve,
they're not throwing it in your. They're not like, hey, Tom, look, we're doing a pool. You don't have one. They're not doing that.
Everything everybody does is to hurt me, and I know this. And it's not that I'm paranoid. It's just that I know it.
Tom,
they're shoving it in my
face.
So
tell me about their pool. It sounds exciting.
Well, it was interesting to see that grub hole go in there. You know, the back hole. And they started digging it out, and you know, big smiles on their face. And they got their kids in their arms.
How exciting for
them.
And
I thought, yeah, this is
wonderful.
Did you
ever want a pool, Tom?
Every minute of my life. And yes, I really wanted that. No,
okay.
We're looking at snow blowers.
Okay,
because I got to get rid of the old snow blower and do something new.
Yeah, my apartment has a pool, Tom. You can come over.
Well, that's nice. Well, then there's that other thing that I don't want to be seen in public with, you know, my shirt off.
Yeah, right? Well, that's okay.
These days.
If it helps at all, the public doesn't want to see you with your shirt off either. So
I carry around a little box filled with Polaroids of when I used to bodybuild, and I keep it right next to me. And like I pretend like I'm shuffling them out, just, oh, yeah, no, that's really me. That was really me.
Yeah, I have pictures, Tom, of when I was 6'6" and weighed 98 pounds.
Yeah.
So, it was, you know,
Steve was a walking stick. I'm not going to lie to you.
I was a walking stick.
It was pretty funny. Anyway, we're going to talk with Natasha Schmidt right now, better looking and smarter, co-owner of Rubberstone New York, rubberstonenY.com. Why is Rubberstone CNY on here? That was never that.
Just to make you look bad.
I know. It's not even supposed to be here.
We got to keep you on your toes.
Right. Well,
I know it's rubberstonenY.com. Check it out, folks. Lots of nice pictures there. How are you?
I'm well, thanks. How are you?
Very good. Very good.
Good.
So, you know, I guess we got to say summer's wound down. You know, we're into fall.
Tom does.
Right.
I was waiting for that lovely into the fall edition.
Well, no, yes, I did that at the beginning.
He was like, it's the midwinter edition.
Yes,
that's
Tom.
Oh,
yeah. I got to throw that in next week.
Just to bug me.
Absolutely. So, you know, Rubberstone covers all the ugly concrete and the splits and the heavings and unevenness and all that stuff,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
So you do a lot around pools. Are you mm-hmm. done with all the pools right now, or are you still covering
it
pools?
It is done.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've officially closed.
Wah, 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 wah.
2022 is wrapped up.
Yeah.
It's in the books, but we are looking forward to spring. It's never too early to book.
Right. Yep.
Didn't you tell us you're doing Rubberstone on Tom's neighbor's pool in the spring?
Yeah, right?
I thought
I've
about
actually
it.
Already got him. Yep, already got him on the list.
So will you still do garages at this point so that people can enjoy their garage in the winter?
We are booked. So
no way.
It's
even
done.
Booked for that. Yeah.
Yep. It's,
how about a basement?
Basements. We can do.
Basements. Yeah.
Yes. So seriously, that's a huge part of mm-hmm. of what you guys do.
Right. Mm-hmm. Especially mm-hmm. in the winter time.
Absolutely. That's primarily what we do, especially in the residential market.
So talk basements. What do you do? What does it look like? Why should anybody
Yeah.
bother?
What's the product?
Yeah. Yeah. So we have two options. Really, you could choose any of the three options that we offer for your basement. Most commonly chosen is the Rubberstone. Rubberstone takes a concrete, you know, cold, maybe semi-damp basement into a usable, welcoming, warm, inviting area. So the floor is soft, the floor is warm. It doesn't damage under water exposure, so you don't have to worry about mold, mildew, popping, lifting, any type of deterioration.
What color is it?
You pick it, we stick it. It's any color you can think of, we can put it down there. We have over 20 different colors of Rubberstone that can be mixed and matched to suit anything you already have going on down there, or it's a good base to start on that finished area, that additional living space.
And I don't want to confuse people because the name can be a little confusing when you say Rubberstone.
Mm-hmm.
There is no stone in the rubber that you're putting down there.
Is there rubber in it?
It's really, it's
is
predominantly
one true?
It's 100% rubber.
Okay. 100% rubber.
That's why it's warm and
exactly,
you know, squishy and
exactly
stuff.
Right. But we do have a stone alternative, and, a 100% natural stone alternative, which is very commonly used in basements. It has the same longevity and the same warranty when we're installing in basements, but it doesn't have the same softness, but it is a bit more elegant, a bit more upgraded feel overall to the product with the natural stone and the shininess to it.
Let's talk about how, well, you're completely booked for the garages. I wanted to talk about the garages because.
So go back to basements. Like, but, Tom, did you know I put a floor in the basement of our old house?
Yes, I saw your parquet floor that got ruined, right?
And then, diddle-a-doo, you have the leak, you have the water. You know, it was, I think the water tank, because our basement didn't even have a sump pump. But anyway, forget about it. And there was a lot of work. It was a lot of money, quite frankly.
Right.
And I was unaware of rubber stone at the time. What a difference that would have been.
Oh, yeah.
You know, have that thing wall to wall, sealed rubber. It'd be like, boop, little in, little out, squeegee down the hole, right?
That's it. You can shot back out the loose water and run your dehumidifier. That's it.
So there's never, basements leak. Mm-hmm. I don't care what house.
Well, sure. Yeah. Weeping, you know, weeping walls.
Everything. So is that primarily why people pick rubber stone or for other reasons?
I think there's a whole gamut of reasons of why people pick rubber stone. I think most people wind up choosing rubber stone over other things because of the longevity. So it's a lifetime floor. It's a one and done system. Mm-hmm. You know, once it's down, it's down, and we don't have to do anything else. And it comes with a 20-year warranty. So if something was to go haywire downstairs and the floor did something it wasn't supposed to, it's going to be covered under a warranty for 20 years.
What if somebody dropped something and, you know, split the rubber in a certain place?
I don't know what they would be dropping, sir.
Because it would have to be really. So it's very unlikely.
It's very unlikely because pretty much anything you drop on rubber is just going to like bounce around and kind of just fall off. But a hammer, a bowling ball, a knife.
Like if somebody was weightlifting,
it's still made for that.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. It can withstand all of that type of pressure.
So you are taking bookings to get the basements covered. Mm-hmm. You could do somebody's vestibule, the front,
breezeway or a mud room. Yep.
Yeah. That would be kind of cool.
Talk Parade of Homes. I just remembered. You're Parade of Homes.
Parade of Homes. We will be in the Parade of Homes. That starts, mid-October? But we are doing one garage out there this year, which is fine with me because we did three last year, and that was a lot.
Right.
So one garage. We're doing it in rubber. We'll be in the Mark Anthony home.
Anthony.
Mark
There's
Anthony.
There's no thought to it,
There's
is there?
There's no the there.
Okay, so you did the garage there.
Yeah, we did the garage there. So that's great because garages are our number one seller during season. So you come in there and see it in its context, in its usable form.
Right.
Answer some questions, grab some literature and some samples, and then give us a call because we'll still estimate all year round. So
So now's the time, here.
Oh, yeah.
Always. Because you want to get on the dock.
For whatever it is time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, regardless, pool decks, patios, walkways, garages, basements, call us now. Beat the crowd that comes in from doing the Parade of Homes, and then that just kind of segues us into the home show, and you definitely want to get in before that.
That's wonderful. We're going to be talking with Mary Thompson from the Home Builders, and we're going to get more in detail about all the particulars about the Parade of Homes. But that's great that you're up there. I really like that.
Yeah, you got rubber stone on your sidewalk, right?
I do have it on the sidewalk. And, I should tell people that, she's obviously told people before, that when the sun hits it in the wintertime, and we do get a lot of sun in the winter, it hits it, it melts right away. So, like, if you go out and shovel and you don't have to, like, dig right into it. You can just get the skim coat off it. The sun hits it. It melts right off.
Yep.
And it's kind of warm.
Can you see your neighbor's new pool from there?
No, that's in the backyard.
Okay, just check it.
What my wife doesn't know is I've got four estimates coming. Okay. So,
that's awesome.
That's what's going to happen.
Fabulous.
Whether she likes it or not. Well, look, Natasha, it's always a pleasure, and I know you've had a very busy season.
Mm-hmm.
We wish you the best of luck in the wintertime,
and then
best in spring, too. But we'll be talking to you more.
Mm-hmm.
All right, have a great rest of the day.
Thanks, do the same.
Awesome. So coming up, we're going to talk with Mary Thompson. She's the Executive Director of the Home Builders and Remodelers of CNY. Why obviously put on the parade and the home show in the spring, so that'll be an interesting conversation. Stay riveted right here, 106.9 FM and 570 WSYR.